We had a very productive meeting, and in the middle of the meeting, we were told that the RSS BJP agenda is progressing further and that the RBI chief has resigned because he can no longer work with the government, current government. There was consensus in the room that we have to stop the BJP's assault on our institutions, stop the assault on the CBI, on the RBI, on the Election Commission, on all institutions, assault on the Constitution. There was consensus in the room that the BJP's corruption on Rafael, demonetization, other areas is simply not acceptable, and we are going to fight it, and we are going to do whatever we can to expose it. And there was a consensus that we are going to work together to defeat the BJP-RSS combination. We are also going to have similar coordination in the future. We're going to work both inside Parliament and outside. So, if any of the other senior Sharaji.
One by one, please. Let her speak. Not everybody together.
Sorry? Yes. Yeah, it is. Look, what is happening, frankly, is the government is getting more and more desperate. The government is taking measures that are dangerous for our country. The RBI governor has resigned because he is protecting the institution of the RBI and he is not able to function. Taking away the reserves from the RBI to save your skin, to atone for the sins that you have done, to try and fix the mismanagement that you have done, is an act that is against this nation. And I'm very, very proud, frankly, that people in all walks of life, in all institutions, are now standing up and saying it's not going to be tolerated. We are not going to tolerate what is happening in the CBI, what is happening in the RBI, and what is happening to every other institution in this country. And all of us are saying this in one voice. Right. Why is that a major victory? No. Sorry. It's nothing to do with a major victory. The major victory, the question here is the following. The farmers of this country are committing suicide daily. They do not have access to the Indian banking system. Vijay Mallya stole 9,000 crore rupees. Mr. Nirav Modi has stolen 35,000 crore rupees with his friend Mehul Choksi, who are close to the Prime Minister, and the list goes on. So it's not the question of Vijay Mallya being extradited, it's the question of the Indian banking system being handed over to Mr. Modi's friends. It's called crony capitalism. This is, my friend, this is a process. And as you can see, this process is bringing together everybody, and this process is going to be carried out in a open, friendly, respectful manner. As I said in the room, that the voices in this room are the voices of opposition in this country, and we respect every single one of them. Regardless how big or how small they are, we respect each one of them. The goal of everybody is to defeat the BJP and protect India's constitution and our institutions. No, one second. Bringing Mallya back, Mallya took 9,000 crore rupees from the Indian banking system. Why not talk about Rafael? Let's talk about Rafael. Right, where the Prime Minister personally handed 30,000 crore rupees to Anil Ambani. Let's talk about that. Why does the Prime Minister not have a word to say about this? You're laughing when every time I say this, you smile at me. Right? But why does the Prime Minister not open his mouth about his friend Anil Ambani? Why does the Prime Minister not say that the President of France, no less, the ex-President of France has said that we were given the order. हमें हिंदुस्तान के प्रधानमंत्री ने साफ बता दिया कि अनिल अंबानी को कॉन्ट्रैक्ट मिलना चाहिए तो भ्रष्टाचार की बात करनी है तो राफेल की बात करिए